Hey everybody, how are y'all doing? I am doing so fine. Actually, I'm not. I'm a little nervous. I'm getting ready to go to the grocery store to pick up a grocery order that was placed by my friends, MJ and DT, over at Eat Up First. We're gonna be doing a collab. I have no idea what I'm gonna be cooking. He's placed the order. I'm gonna go grab the groceries and then I'm hoping I have some directions on how to make the meal. If not, I'm sure it's gonna be something from one of his YouTube videos. Y'all wish me luck. I'm on my way to Harris Teeter, y'all. I'm a little nervous because MJ's kind of a gourmet cook, y'all. I'm not, but I'm gonna make it happen. I'm gonna make it happen. Okay, so I'm here at Harris Teeter. As soon as I drove up, a guy walks to my car. Like, I hadn't even put it in park yet. He was like, hey, you here to pick up the order for MJ? I was like, yeah. So he's running in to grab it. I can't wait to see what it's going to be. I'm so excited. And I just can't hide it. I'm about to lose control and I think I like it. Hey. Anyways, y'all, I'm very excited because I know MJ is such a great cook, and I know that whatever that's in that bag, whatever he's gonna have me cooking, is going to be awesome and outstanding all by itself. And then by the time I'm done cooking it, hey, look, y'all are gonna be calling me Chef Senora Lena. Hey! Anyways, y'all. Yes, sir. You can just hand it to me. Thank you very much. You have a good one.
Have a good one.
Okay, y'all. I got the goodies, y'all. Ooh, the bags are stapled. Can't wait to see what's in those bags. Y'all stay tuned. Okay, y'all. I have picked up the food from the grocery store. I'm so excited to see what's in these bags. Okay, so we have some fresh garlic. That's a wonderful way to kickstart this meal. I love fresh garlic. Okay, we got some tortillas. Woo! This is my language right here because Mexican food is my all-time favorite food. Love. Oh Lord, what are these? Oh wait a minute, are these tomatillos? Tomatillos, something like that. T-O-M-A-T-I-L-L-O-S, I think. Oh wait a minute. So these are tomatillos, I think that's what you call them. Interesting, okay. And I have a wonderful onion, AKA onion. Wonderful onion. Hey! Okay, let's see what else we got. Oh, avocado. Can't go wrong with avocado. I love avocado. I can eat a whole one every single morning. And over here we have, okay, what's in here? So, oh, this is a, so we got, I can definitely do this. I can make this happen. Let's see what else we got. Okay, jalapenos. Can't go wrong with jalapenos. I just hope they're hot enough because I love jalapenos. Ooh, these are fat ones too. Woo! Mmm, smells something really good, y'all. Okay, and this is, let's see. This looks like cilantro maybe? Cilantro or, I don't think it's parsley. I think it's gotta be cilantro. Yes, this is cilantro. This right here, I love the way cilantro smells and I also love the way it tastes. So we're really off to an excellent start here. Okay, and the last thing that we have is, okay, are these limes? Two limes. Okay. I hope I'm not gonna be zesting. I bet you I'm gonna have to zest or something like that. We'll see. So, I think what I'm gonna be making, I'm just gonna guess here. I'm making no clue. No clue yet. But whatever it is, it's going to be wonderful. This is my first time using tomatillos. I'm pretty sure that's what you call them. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, but it's something like that. Tomatillos. So we have tortillas, beautiful steak, onion, two limes, avocado, a couple of fat, juicy, delicious jalapenos, fresh garlic, cilantro, tomatillas. This is gonna be so ridiculously good, it's not even funny. Because by the time I'm done preparing this meal, hey, look, you better ask somebody. I'm gonna be getting ready to open up my own restaurant. Y'all stay tuned. I think I need to go and freshen up, put my apron on, and I'm gonna get started on this wonderful meal. Okay, y'all, I have started to put the contents of my salsa into my little KitchenAid food processor here. I had a little snafu earlier. Couldn't figure out how to get the thing to turn on. This is my first time using it, actually. It's not a cheap food processor, so it was quite frustrating. When I tried to get the thing to turn on, it just wouldn't do anything. But it was my fault. I just wasn't doing it properly. Hopefully now, it will work for me. Okay, there we go. Let's get this plugged in here. I'm gonna give it a few pulses to puree it. That's just about to the consistency that I want. Okay, let's give it a look here. See if it looks like MJ's. Ooh, wonderful. Look at this, y'all. That looks wonderful. Now, I know that MJ put an ice cube. I had some ice cubes in here. They have since melted because I couldn't figure out how to get my blender going here for my food processor. So let's pulsate this a little bit more. Okay, I think that's lovely right there. Once I figured out how to use this thing, it was quite nice. Okay, there we go. Let's just take that out. Dump this in here. Scoop it out. Ooh, that looks so wonderful, doesn't it? Ooh, yummy. I cannot wait to put this onto my wonderful steak tacos. Okay, let me get this out of here. I just absolutely love avocados. I put in a little bit more of the jalapeno pepper. I had some spicy ones in my refrigerator, so I swapped out the ones that I had roasted, and I threw some other ones in the roasting pan. And let those cook up nicely. This looks absolutely beautiful. It smells amazing in here. So this is definitely something I can see me use, see myself making in the future, just because it smells so good. Actually, let me taste it here. Woo! Mighty good. Wonderful. You know what? I can eat all of that in one sitting. Grab a bag of tortilla chips or a steak taco. Put some of that on there. And voila, I have a tasty snack. This is actually very delicious. Please try it. The lime gives it a very nice flavor. And okay, I think that's good here. Yeah, there we go. Okay, and there is my tomatilla avocado salsa. I'm gonna go in with just a little olive oil. Wonderful. And boom, there's my wonderful salsa. Okay, so now it's time to get this steak going. Let me get my stove turned on here. Y'all, I have some wonderful steak here. It's already been washed and cleaned and everything. I'm just gonna go in with a little bit of sea salt, not too much. And some fresh black pepper. As I stated, I actually love black pepper. I love, love, love spicy foods. So, okay. Now I have a question for y'all. How old is the oldest spice in your cabinet? For me, probably, oh, I don't know. I've had some spices that were 10 and 11 years old that I ended up using. And you know what? It tasted just fine. I don't know if spices actually ever really go bad. Do they actually go bad? I'm not sure about that. I feel like you can just use them, you know? Okay, so I got my salt and pepper on here. And I'm so tempted to put some of this on there. This is that true lime, garlic, and cilantro seasoning that just goes wonderfully well on avocados and things like that. So I think I won't do that. I'm not gonna step outside of the recipe here because I wanna make sure that it turns out perfectly, which I think it will. Hopefully that water is hot enough. I'm sorry, that grease is hot enough. Okay, it's just about hot enough. I cannot wait to actually sit back and enjoy these steak tacos. I'm going to have them with salad. I was going to do rice, but I've had rice so many times this week. It's just like enough already, enough with the rice. Now I know MJ cooks his medium rare. As I said earlier, I guess about 4 minutes per side. I'm not gonna do that because I faint at the sight of blood. Yes, this is hot enough. We're gonna go on in with these. I like my steaks or any meat that I eat to be very, very well done. If it's not very well done, I don't want it. So I'm gonna cook this exactly the way that I want it. Don't know how long per side, just till it's done, you know? Just till it's done. And it's actually kind of fun cooking this steak. I don't even buy steak once a year anymore. So this is gonna be a nice treat for me. So I'm gonna let this cook, like I said, maybe 5 minutes per side. And then when it's all nice and done, we're gonna come back, gonna plate this up, and taste these bad boys. Okay, y'all, my steak is done, and I have to say, I've been nibbling on it. It's so delicious. It actually turned out much better than I expected it to turn out. It seasoned so very well. And I say it turned out better than expected because I am not someone who really knows how to cook steak. And to me, this is absolutely perfect. It's not undercooked, it's not overcooked. It's exactly the way that I like. Oh my gosh, it's tender. I don't usually do too well when I'm making steak. This is actually very tender. I'm so pleased. This is a really good cut of meat here. And I cannot wait to chomp into these steak tacos. I don't know if I can eat two, but I'm definitely gonna try to, y'all. Why not, right? I'm gonna have a nice salad. It's gonna do a little bit of rice, but I literally have had rice every day for about 5 or 6 days. So I'm just gonna do a nice little garden salad with this and just enjoy it. I am so happy that I made this recipe here, because it turned out very well. It wasn't very difficult to make. You know, there's not too many ingredients. Everything can be found at the grocery store. Even the tomatillas, you know, I've never purchased them from the grocery store before. I've seen them, but, and it's, you know, I've just never purchased them. And now I know that I can definitely go ahead and purchase them and make something really delicious from them. Y'all. Hold on 1 second, y'all. You know what? Sometimes you have to give yourself a round of applause. That's seasoned extremely well. So delicious. I'm gonna push that aside. And I'm going to spread some of this wonderful salsa. Look at this. Do you see how beautiful that salsa is? Isn't that lovely? I kind of hate to dip into it because it's so beautiful. Let me see if I can make this pretty, y'all. I'm gonna try here. Put a little bit of 2 or 3 jalapenos on there. Get a little bit of cilantro on there. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited about this because I feel like I've just made my first truly gourmet meal. You know what I'm saying? I'm not a gourmet cook. I would love to be a gourmet cook. MJ is definitely, look, he can make gourmet goulash, okay? So here's my wonderful steak tacos. I'm just gonna do a little bit of a garden salad here on the side. I love this fresh spring mix. It's just a beautiful lettuce. I love it. I love the multicolors of it. So I'm just gonna do a little bit of lettuce like that. I love tomatoes. Tomatoes, tomatoes, potatoes, potatoes. I just love them. Okay, that's enough of that there. And probably just a scotch of cheese. Just a scotch. Okay. Drizzle a little bit of salad dressing on there. The next thing I want to do is learn how to make a nice vinaigrette. It can't be that hard. I'm sure it's just a matter of olive oil, maybe some lemon, some garlic, some dried onions and things like that. So here's my wonderful dish, okay? I'm going to have a seat, take a bite of this, and let y'all know exactly what time it is. Hey y'all, I am going to give this a taste test. I was gonna do it off camera because it might be a little messy because I slathered a lot of that wonderful salsa on there, but I'm just gonna go in. I'm gonna be very real with you all. You know what? This tastes like I'm sitting down to a very nice steak dinner at a very classy restaurant. This is some of the best steak I've had. absolutely delicious. The salsa is such a wonderful, mild, yet flavorful accompaniment to this steak burrito or steak taco. I'm actually gonna eat both of these, y'all. Hang on 1 second. Make you wanna hurt somebody, but don't do it. The only thing I need now is a nice tall glass of iced tea and one more bite of this. I'm gonna go in this way, y'all, hold on. Y'all, make some. This is a bomb. Make some. All right, y'all have a wonderful evening, day, afternoon. Not sure what time you're gonna see this video, but I did that thing. I actually made tender steak without undercooking it. I think a lot of times people eat their steaks medium rare is because they say it's more tender, but that's very, very, very tender. All right, y'all. Peace out. Talk to you later.
Hey guys, so I'm here to pick up my order from a fellow YouTuber who sent a bag of, or she ordered a bag of just mystery ingredients. She wants me to make one of her recipes. So she's in Raleigh, North Carolina. And so I'm excited. I'm excited to see what's in this bag. Full of ingredients, just full of stuff for me to cook. I believe this is her recipe. So we shall see. Hopefully I can do it some justice. All right, thank you. You too. So here's the order of stuff. All right, guys, well, I'm back from HEB, from picking up my secret ingredients of what my friend over in North Carolina sent over. So let's go through the bag and see what all she sent over. So here we have ground cumin, chili powder, collard greens. We have a yellow onion. We have some kielbasa, beef sausage. We have a red pepper, a green pepper, there's some Carolina Reaper. It's cheese, Carolina Reaper. This is some white rice. She sent over some beef broth, black-eyed peas, more black-eyed peas, and more beef broth. So these are all the ingredients that she has sent over, and I'm going to create a dish that she created, her YouTube channel. So I'm excited about that. I will be posting a link to her YouTube channel at the bottom. So let's get to cooking. I'm gonna start off by rinsing the vegetables first and cutting up what I need to, and then we will get to cooking. So I will be back. About 2 tablespoons of olive oil into this countertop grill.
I'm gonna keep it about 275. I'm making it in here because it's black IP chili. So I need something that can hold all this. So let's start off by browning our pound of kielbasa. And obviously you can use, if you have andouille sausage or your sausage or whatever you have, feel free to use that. I am going to use what she ordered. So we are going to let this brown for a little bit, and then we will add in our onions and our peppers that I have already chopped. You know, I'm super excited about this. I watched the video and where she made the steak tacos, and she absolutely loved it. So I'm excited about trying this, and the weather's perfect. So I'm super excited. I go on vacation in the next, so I leave on the 23rd. So I'm going to Puerto Morelos, and I am super excited. So now that this is brown, it's pretty brown, this sausage, this kielbasa is brown, I will go ahead and add the onion and the peppers. You know, and I just chopped these up. I diced them up and this stuff. Nice little, and you don't want anything too chopped up, but nice size pieces. And this is a chili. I've never had black eyed pea chili, but I'm excited to try this. I'm really excited. This just smells amazing already, just with this. Right, guys, so I'm gonna have to take this old school because my can opener broke. So, listen, I've got this, so that's what I'm going to use. Alright guys, so at this stage I will go ahead and add in, so she sent over chili powder and ground cumin. So I am going to add about a teaspoon and a half of ground cumin. I will add just a little bit more cumin. I love cumin, so you can add as much as you want when you make it yourself. Now this is chili powder. I am not going to add that much, but I will add a little bit in there. I'm probably gonna do about a teaspoon. I won't put that much because my stomach can handle all that. You can, and you go ahead and do it. Here I'm adding it some thyme, some fresh thyme, and this is all the aromatics that are going into this black eyed pea chili. Oh yeah, that smells wonderful. That thyme just adds a little freshness to this. Here we are putting in our two cans of beef stock, and I'm going to turn this up to about 400 so I can get a boil on this, get this to a rolling boil. This already looks absolutely amazing. And I did drain these. I will be adding in two fresh bay leaves. So I'm gonna go ahead and add two. And I'm going to let this cook for about a good 20 minutes, 25 minutes. I am going to add in the garlic that I forgot to add earlier. And I'll bring it back up to a little boil and then just let it, I would let it cook for about another 10 minutes. I'm hungry, man. I'm always hungry. This just... So I've added this, the collard greens. I'm gonna let this cook for about a good 15 minutes. I don't want these to be, I still want these with a little bite, a little crunch. This tastes, I can just smell and taste it already. So guys, this is the black eyed pea collard green chili. So I'm going to top it. She sent over, she ordered some, this is called Carolina Reaper pepper cheese. So I am going to put a little bit of this in there. And I'm also going to just put a little bit of, squeeze a little lime juice in mine. And I made this Lebna last week. And so I am going to add a dollop of this as well. Hi guys, so I am going to give this a try. Ooh, it looks so good. In the name of Jesus. Oh man. This is awesome. Just that kielbasa is so good in this, and then you get the taste of that collard green and all the veggies and then the bean. All right, Lena, you did your thing. I'm gonna eat.